If you have any questions, if they already have tickets, you're not sure, we do have a seat over at the bike. You need to make sure that they can sit on the seat with their feet touching the ground flat, which you might just raise.
You are
so if a child's sitting, their feet are dangling, they're not going to be able to reach the bike pedals, they're not going to be able to pedal back and forth. It's just not going to be a fun ride for them. You also want to make sure that they meet the weight requirement. You don't allow anyone over 250 pounds on the bike. So if you have any concerns, if a guest comes with a ticket and you have concerns that maybe they weigh a little too much, don't feel bad having to ask them their weight. We have three different harness sizes. They are all adult sizes. We have small, medium, and large. For most children, we want a small size. Your biggest men for the most part. Harnesses are all adjustable and they are all labeled somewhere. There's a small. So even like smaller adults are going to be a small size harness. The harness goes on like a backpack. And we have three main sets of buckles that we always want to be sure to buckle. We have the chest strap, and for these you can ask a visitor if they would like to do this themselves. It is a little personal, but you want to be sure that this chest strap is tight enough that these aren't going to fall over the shoulders. You can adjust that by pulling this tighter. We also have the belt. And again, don't squeeze them, but be sure it's nice and snug. And then we have our two leg straps. For older visitors, I will ask them to reach through their legs and grab those straps for me and pull them around front. Again, it's kind of keeps you out of their personal space. Some of the little riders, they might need a little bit more help. And then we attach these. If you have an especially small rider, if they can still touch their feet, but the harness is a little big and it's sagging, sometimes you'll get these, the leg straps will be down around their knees. We do have an alternate way that we can buckle. And for this one, I will ask them to take their leg straps, and I want you to grab your leg straps and I want you to hold them up to your chest. All right. And then you will buckle the waistband, and then you'll pull these down and buckle the rest of the way. Obviously, she's not a very small child, so it doesn't fit that way. That's a good way to kind of modify it. That way it doesn't hang around the knees, so it doesn't get them snagged up when they get on the bike. All right, so let's go ahead and finish getting you harnessed up. Number one, it rides on a high wire, not a rope. So if you look at the wheels, they have a groove in them. That groove is designed to fit into a large metal cable that spans across our third floor. This cable is about 25 feet off the ground. You can see our first floor down below with some of our exhibits. You also see a net. What do you think that net's for?
Safety.
It is definitely for safety. Most visitors will suggest that the net is in case they fall off the bike. Again, it's important to remind them that they cannot fall off the bike. Again, the bike can't fall down, you're strapped in, but that's in case we lose something. So if your shoe falls off, if your sunglasses or your hat falls off, that net catches it so that you hit somebody down below. This is a good time you might want to check if they are wearing some sort of shoes that easily come off, if they're wearing flip-flops, if they feel more comfortable riding barefoot, they can. The net catches things, it's very difficult to get stuff out of the net. I suggest to start out riding the bike that we start with our feet either on the pedals or on the bike. And so go ahead and put your feet on the pedals for a minute there. Now, you are riding the bike right now. Alright, if you look down, there is nothing touching the bike. This yellow platform that I'm standing on is not touching the bike. Alright, it is actually balancing on its own. Now, if you look down below here, what do you see? A weight, yeah. It's a giant purple weight. It's a big chunk of metal. That metal weighs about 300 pounds. Now, do you weigh more than 300 pounds? No. So, if gravity's pulling on that 300 pounds and it's pulling on you, which one's gonna be heavier? Which one's gonna pull more on? The weight, obviously. That's why we don't let anybody over about 250 pounds recognize. So gravity's pulling more on that weight, it's gonna keep that weight below you at all times, which is what keeps the bike balanced. Alright? Now, for younger visitors, I will usually ask them to start out with their feet up on the front of the bike here. So would you mind putting your feet just if you can there you go. Some of the older visitors might prefer to start out pedaling backwards. Especially for the younger guys, I'll have them start with their feet on here. I ask them to keep their feet on the bike until it comes to a stop. All right, we unclip the safety chain. And then here, feel free to hold on either the front handlebars or you can hold on to the side. Some people are more comfortable kind of sitting upright's a little bit more, more stable. All right, it's gonna feel a little weird going backwards on the bicycle. But we'll roll out kind of into the middle there and it'll come to a stop. When it comes to a stop, then you can put your feet on the pedals. Let it go. And I like to let each visitor have a good like 2, 3, 4 passes on the wire. It kind of depends on how many people are waiting. If you have a large field trip group, you might want to run it through a little bit quicker. Obviously, we don't have anyone waiting right now, so you can try out a little bit more. But we start out just with pedaling. All right. I want you to go ahead and pedal backwards out the middle, and I want you to stop. Until that rope catches and is pulled taut. And then you always want to reattach our safety chain. Then you can unbuckle the rider. Ask them to step off on the left side. Help them exit, and then we get them unharnessed. Again, always make sure that the gate gets closed back when you're not in there.